Good morning, students. This is your English teacher, Mrs. Suman Srivastava, and welcome back to the online session of your English classes. Yesterday, we learned about the problems we are facing due to raising of livestock. So now, we will have a quick revision for the same. Firstly, we learned about the increasing demand of meat due to which we are facing deforestation problem. We also learned about scarcity of water for drinking and growing crops due to raising of livestock. Then we came to know about US, United States, its state Utah, and its largest city, Los Angeles, facing many problems due to raising livestock. After this, I ended the topic by showing you this picture. Now, we will proceed with the next part of the chapter. Eating a lot of meat can lead to a number of health problems, such as increased obesity, heart disease, and various forms of cancer. The various chemicals fed to livestock these days are also a matter of serious concern. The long-term effects of eating meat from these animals can be terrible. Here, it's given that many health problems arises for the people who eats a lot of meat. Problems such as obesity. Obesity means a state in which a person becomes very fat. So, many health problems arises like obesity, heart disease, and other forms of cancer. You all might be knowing that for raising the livestock to be big, healthy, and fat, they are fed with food contains chemicals for making them look big and grow fast. And this is also a matter of serious concern, as for the people who are non-vegetarian may eat this kind of meat, and indirectly these chemicals will enter their bodies causing various diseases. And if a person eats this kind of meat for long term, then the effect can be terrible. Next para. Some people argue that vegetarian food can be short of protein. But this is not true. Plenty of protein can be obtained from articles such as peas, beans, nuts, seeds, pulses, cereals, soya, and milk products. Some says that vegetarian food have less protein than the non-vegetarian food. But this is not true, as we can get lots of protein from vegetarian food like peas, beans, nuts, seeds, pulses, cereals, milk products, etc. Here, cereals means a type of food grain that can be eaten or can be used to make flour, rye, wheat, etc. Vegetarians have invented for themselves high protein vegetable foods such as peanut butter, corn flakes, and muesli. So, vegetarians have also invented some high protein vegetable food. They are peanut butter, corn flakes, and muesli. Now, what do you mean by muesli? Muesli is a mixture of grains, nuts, dried fruits, and served with milk to eat for breakfast. Now, next para. In fact, vegetarian products are rich in all kinds of nutrients. Leafy and root vegetables provide vitamins, minerals, and fibers that help to keep our digestion working properly. Vegetarians can obtain iron from pumpkin, oats, nuts, and sesame. They can obtain calcium from cheese, yogurt, almond, green leafy vegetables, and soya. Potatoes contain starches which the body can burn up to make energy. In fact, vegetarian products like milk products, vegetables, fruits are all rich in all kinds of nutrients. About nutrients, I already told you in the previous chapter, that is carbohydrates, fats, vitamins, fiber, proteins, starches, etc. So, we get vitamins, minerals and fibers from leafy and root vegetables. Root vegetables like carrots and radish, which helps to keep our digestion work properly. Iron can be obtained from oats, pumpkin, nuts and sesame. Sesame in Hindi we called as til. Vegetarian can also get calcium from cheese, yogurt, soya, etc. and starches from potatoes, which the body burns up to make energy. Last two lines. Do you know the elephant is the biggest and the strongest of land animals and is a vegetarian? It kills no animal for its food. At last, this example is given over here that an elephant is the biggest and the strongest of land animals and is a vegetarian too. And it kills no animal for its food because the elephant is a vegetarian animal, not a non-vegetarian animal. So here our chapter's explanation ends and we will proceed with the next topic tomorrow. Thank you, children.